So I am repeating the process of spermatogenesis, just a revision. First of all there are primordial germ cells which arise from epiblast at second week of fertilization. From there they migrate to yolk sac and finally reach the genital ridge of developing gonads at the end of fifth week. Now these primordial germ cells, they form the type A spermatogonia in males, that is diploid. Okay, so these type A spermatogonia, they remain dormant in the seminiferous tubules until puberty. Okay, and at puberty they undergo mitotic division 5 times and forms type B spermatogonia. This I have told because question comes that one spermatogonia gives rise to how many spermatids at the end. This is 512 spermatids, and this you can count yourself, that if one cell it is dividing again and again, it will form 512 spermatids at the end. So these type B spermatogonia, which are total approximately 64 in number after 5 divisions. Okay. These type B spermatogonia, they will form the primary spermatocytes, which are again diploid. These primary spermatocyte, they undergo meiosis 1 and form secondary spermatocyte, which are haploid. Now the question comes that independent assortment of chromosomes occur during, you need not cram. Simply remember, like supposingly a cell is 46XY, it has to undergo meiosis 1. Now out of these, which chromosome will go to which cell, that is how these chromosomes will get assorted, this is a totally independent process. Rest of the chromosomes are same, but out of X and Y, which chromosome will go where? So this thing is independent assortment, that this assortment of these chromosomes is totally independent. Okay, so these secondary spermatocytes, that is haploid, they undergo mitosis again and form spermatids, okay, which are again haploid. Spermatids are round, they undergo spermiogenesis to form the mature spermatozoa. These mature spermatozoa are elongated. Okay, again these are haploid gametes.